This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Danelaw, also known as the Danelagh, Old English, Dena lagu, Danish, Danelagen, as recorded in the Anglo-Saxon Chronicle, is a historical name given to the part of England in which the laws of the Danes held sway and dominated those of the Anglo-Saxons. Danelaw contrasts West Saxon law and Mercian law. Modern historians have extended the term to a geographical designation. The areas that constituted the Danelaw lie in northern and eastern England. The Danelaw originated from the Viking expansion of the 9th century AD, although the term was not used to describe a geographic area until the 11th century AD with the increase in population and productivity in Scandinavia. Viking warriors, having sought treasure and glory in the nearby British Isles, proceeded to plough and support themselves. In the words of the Anglo-Saxon Chronicle for the year 876, Danelaw can describe the set of legal terms and definitions created in the treaties between the West Saxon king, Alfred the Great, and the Danish warlord, Guthrum, written following Guthrum's defeat at the Battle of Edding. In 878. In 886, the Treaty of Alfred and Guthrum was formalized, defining the boundaries of their kingdoms, with provisions for peaceful relations between the English and the Vikings. The language spoken in England was also affected by this clash of cultures with the emergence of Anglo-Norse dialects. The Danelaw roughly comprised 14 shires: York, Nottingham, Derby, Lincoln, Essex, Cambridge, Suffolk, Norfolk, Northampton, Huntingdon, Bedford, Hertford, Middlesex and Buckingham. Contents 1. Background 2. Establishment of Danish self-rule 3. Canute and his successors 4. Danish-Norwegian conflict in the North Sea 5. Chronology 6. Geography 7. Legal concepts 8. Legacy 9. Genetic heritage 10. Archaeology 11. See also 12. References 13. Further reading 14. External links. Background: Map of England showing the Anglo-Saxon kingdoms and Danish districts, from Cassell's History of England, Volume 1, anonymous author and artists from around 800. There had been waves of Danish raids on the coastlines of the British Isles in 865. Instead of raiding, the Danes landed a large army in East Anglia, with the intention of conquering the four Anglo-Saxon kingdoms of England. The armies of various Danish leaders had come together to provide one combined force under a leadership that included Halfdan Ragnarsson and Ivar the Boneless, the sons of the legendary Viking leader Ragnar Lodbrok. The combined army was described in the annals as the Great Heathen Army. After making peace with the local East Anglian king in return for horses, the Great Heathen Army moved north in 867. They captured Northumbria and its capital, York, defeating both the recently deposed King Osbert of Northumbria and the usurper Aella of Northumbria. The Danes then placed an Englishman, Ecgbert I of Northumbria, on the throne of Northumbria as a puppet ruler. King Æthelred of Wessex and his brother Alfred led their army against the Danes at Nottingham, but the Danes refused to leave their fortifications. King Burgred of Mercia then negotiated peace with Ivar, with the Danes keeping Nottingham in exchange for leaving the rest of Mercia alone under Ivar the Boneless. The Danes continued their invasion in 869 by defeating King Edmund of East Anglia at Hoxney and conquering East Anglia once again. The brothers Æthelred and Alfred attempted to stop Ivar by attacking the Danes at Reading. They were repelled with heavy losses. The Danes pursued, and on 7 January 871, Æthelred and Alfred defeated the Danes at the Battle of Ashdown. The Danes retreated to Basing in Hampshire, where Æthelred attacked and was, in turn, defeated. Ivar was able to follow up this victory with another in March at Mareedham, now Marton, Wiltshire, on 23 April 871. King Æthelred died and Alfred succeeded him as King of Wessex. His army was weak and he was forced to pay tribute to Ivar in order to make peace with the Danes. During this peace, the Danes turned to the north and attacked Mercia, a campaign that lasted until 874. Both the Danish leader Ivar and the Mercian leader Burgred died during this campaign. Ivar was succeeded by Guthrum, who finished the campaign against Mercia in 10 years. The Danes had gained control over East Anglia, Northumbria and Mercia, leaving just Wessex resisting. Guthrum and the Danes brokered peace with Wessex in 876, when they captured the fortresses of Wareham and Exeter. Alfred laid siege to the Danes, who were forced to surrender after reinforcements were lost in a storm 2 years later. Guthrum again attacked Alfred, surprising him by attacking his forces wintering in Chippenham. King Alfred was saved when the Danish army coming from his rear was destroyed by inferior forces at the Battle of Cynwy. The modern location of Cynwy is disputed, but suggestions include Countisbury Hill, near Lynmouth, Devon, or Kenwith Castle, Bideford, Devon, or Cannington, near Bridgewater, Somerset. Alfred was forced into hiding for a time, before returning in the spring of 878 to gather an army and attack Guthrum at Edington. The Danes were defeated and retreated to Chippenham, where King Alfred laid siege and soon forced them to surrender as a term of surrender. King Alfred demanded that Guthrum be baptized a Christian. King Alfred served as his godfather, establishment of Danish self-rule. Edward the Elder and his sister, Ethelflaed, the Lady of the Mercians, conquered Danish territories in the Midlands and East Anglia in a series of campaigns in the 910s, and some Danish jarls who submitted were allowed to keep their lands. Viking rule ended when Eric Bloodaxe was driven out of Northumbria in 954. The reasons for the waves of immigration were complex and bound to the political situation in Scandinavia at that time. Moreover, they occurred when Viking settlers were also establishing their presence in the Hebrides, Orkney, the Faroe Islands, Ireland, Iceland, Greenland, France, Normandy, the Balticum, Russia and Ukraine. See Kievan Rus Canute and his successors Canute the Great's domains. The Danes did not give up their designs on England from 1016 to 1035. Canute the Great ruled over a unified English kingdom, itself the product of a resurgent Wessex, as part of his North Sea Empire, together with Denmark, Norway and part of Sweden. Canute was succeeded in England on his death by his son Harald Harefoot, until he died in 1040, after which another of Canute's sons, Harthacnut, took the throne. Since Harthacnut was already on the Danish throne, this reunited the North Sea Empire. Harthacnut lived only another 2 years, and from his death in 1042 until 1066 the monarchy reverted to the English line in the form of Edward the Confessor. Edward died in January 1066 without an obvious successor, and an English nobleman, Harold Godwinson, took the throne in the autumn of that same year. Two rival claimants to the throne led invasions of England in short succession. First, Harald Hardrada of Norway took York in September, but was defeated by Harald at the Battle of Stamford Bridge, in Yorkshire. Then, 3 weeks later, William of Normandy defeated Harald at the Battle of Hastings, in Sussex, and in December he accepted the submission of Edgar the Aetheling, last in the line of Anglo-Saxon kings. At Berkhamsted the Danelaw appeared in legislation as late as the early 12th century with the Leges Henrici Primi, where it is referred to as one of the laws, together with those of Wessex and Mercia, into which England was divided. Danish-Norwegian conflict in the North Sea in the 11th century, when King Magnus I had freed Norway from Canute the Great. The terms of the peace treaty provided that the first of the two kings, Magnus Norway and Harthacnut Denmark, to die would leave their dominion as an inheritance to the other. When Edward the Confessor ascended the throne of a united Dano-Saxon England, a Norse army was raised from every Norwegian colony in the British Isles and attacked Edward's England in support of Magnus, and after his death, his brother Harald Hardrada's claim to the English throne on the accession of Harald Godwinson. After the death of Edward the Confessor, Hardrada invaded Northumbria with the support of Harald's brother Tostig Godwinson, and was defeated at the Battle of Stamford Bridge, 3 weeks before William the First's victory at the Battle of Hastings. Chronology 800 minus waves of Danish assaults on the coastlines of the British Isles. 865 minus Danish raiders first began to settle in England, led by the brothers Halfdan and Ivar the Boneless. They wintered in East Anglia, where they demanded and received tribute in exchange for a temporary peace. From there, they moved north and attacked Northumbria, which was in the midst of a civil war between the deposed King Osbert and a usurper Aella. The Danes used the civil turmoil as an opportunity to capture York, which they sacked and burned. 867 minus following the loss of York, Osbert and Aella formed an alliance against the Danes. They launched a counterattack, but the Danes killed both Osbert and Aella and set up a puppet king on Northumbrian throne in response. King Æthelred of Wessex, along with his brother Alfred, marched against the Danes, who were positioned behind fortifications in Nottingham, but were unable to draw them into battle in order to establish peace. King Burrid of Mercia ceded Nottingham to the Danes in exchange for leaving the rest of Mercia undisturbed. 868- Danes capture Nottingham. 869- Ivar the Boneless returned and demanded tribute from King Edmund of East Anglia. 870- King Edmund refused. Ivar the Boneless defeated and captured him at Hoxney, adding East Anglia to the area controlled by the invading Danes. King Æthelred and Alfred attacked the Danes at Reading, but were repulsed with heavy losses. The Danes pursued them. 871- On 7 January, they made their stand at Ashdown on what is the Berkshire, North Wessex Downs, now in Oxfordshire. Æthelred could not be found at the start of battle, as he was busy praying in his tent, so Alfred led the army into battle. Æthelred and Alfred defeated the Danes, who counted among their losses 5 jarls nobles. The Danes retreated and set up fortifications at Basing-Basingstoke in Hampshire, a mere 14 miles 23. Further worsened by the arrival in Reading of a second Danish army from Europe for the rest of the year, Alfred concentrated on attacking with small bands against isolated groups of Danes. He was moderately successful in this endeavour and was able to score minor victories against the Danes, but his army was on the verge of collapse. Alfred responded by paying off the Danes in order for a promise of peace. During the peace, the Danes turned north and attacked Mercia, which they finished off in short order, and captured London in the process. King Burghred of Mercia fought in vain against the Ivar the Boneless and his Danish invaders for 3 years until 874, when he fled to Europe. During Ivar's campaign against Mercia, he died and was succeeded by Guthrum the Old as the main protagonist in the Danes' drive to conquer England. Guthrum quickly defeated Burghred and placed a puppet on the throne of Mercia. The Danes now controlled East Anglia, Northumbria and Mercia, with only Wessex continuing to resist. 875- The Danes settled in Dorset, well inside of Alfred's Kingdom of Wessex, but Alfred quickly made peace with them. 876- The Danes broke the peace when they captured the fortress of Wareham, followed by a similar capture of Exeter in 877-877- Alfred laid siege, while the Danes waited for reinforcements from Scandinavia. Unfortunately for the Danes, the fleet of reinforcements encountered a storm and lost more than 100 ships, and the Danes were forced to return to East Mercia in the north. 878- In January, Guthrum led an attack against Wessex that sought to capture Alfred while he wintered in Chippenham. Another Danish army landed in South Wales and moved south with the intent of intercepting Alfred should he flee from Guthrum's forces. However, they stopped during their march to capture a small fortress at Countisbury Hill, held by a Wessex ealdorman named Otta. The Saxons, led by Otta, attacked the Danes while they slept and defeated the superior Danish forces, saving Alfred from being trapped between the two armies. Alfred was forced to go into hiding for the rest of the winter and spring of 878 in the Somerset Marshes in order to avoid the superior Danish forces in the spring. Alfred was able to gather an army and attacked Guthrum and the Danes at Eddington. The Danes were defeated and retreated to Chippenham, where the English pursued and laid siege to Guthrum's forces. The Danes were unable to hold out without relief and soon surrendered. Alfred demanded as a term of the surrender that Guthrum become baptized as a Christian, which Guthrum agreed to do, with Alfred acting as his godfather. Guthrum was true to his word and settled in East Anglia, at least for a while. 884-Guthrum attacked Kent, but was defeated by the English. This led to the Treaty of Alfred and Guthrum, which established the boundaries of the Danelaw and allowed for Danish self-rule in the region. 902-Essex submits to Æthelwald. 903-Æthelwald incites the East Anglian Danes into breaking the peace they ravaged Mercia before winning a Pyrrhic victory that saw the death of Æthelwald and the Danish king Eorric. This allows Edward the Elder to consolidate power. 911- The English defeat the Danes at the Battle of Tettenhall. The Northumbrians ravage Mercia but are trapped by Edward and forced to fight. 917- In return for peace and protection, the kingdoms of Essex and East Anglia accept Edward the Elder as their suzerain overlord. Æthelflaed, Lady of the Mercians, takes the borough of Derby. 918- The borough of Leicester submits peaceably to Æthelflaed's rule. The people of York promise to accept her as their overlord, but she dies before this could come to fruition. She is succeeded by her brother. The kingdoms of Mercia and Wessex united in the person of King Edward. 919- Norwegian Vikings under King Ragnvald Sigtryggsson of Dublin take York. 920- Edward is accepted as father and lord by the King of the Scots, by Ragnald, the sons of Edulf, the English, Norwegians, Danes and others, all of whom dwell in Northumbria, and the king and people of the Strathclyde Welsh. 954- King Eric is driven out of Northumbria, his death marking the end of the prospect of a northern Viking kingdom stretching from York to Dublin and the Isles. 1066- Harold Hardrada lands with an army, hoping to take control of York and the English crown. He is defeated and killed at the Battle of Stamford Bridge. This event is often cited as the end of the Viking era. The same year, William the Conqueror, himself a descendant of Norwegian Vikings, successfully took the English throne and became the first Norman king of England. 1069- Swain II of Denmark lands with an army, in much the same way as Harold Hardrada. He took control of York after defeating the Norman garrison and inciting a local uprising. King William eventually defeated his forces and devastated the region in the Harold marrying of the North 1075-1 of Sweyn's sons, Canute, set sail for England to support an English rebellion, but it had been crushed before he arrived, so he settled for plundering the city of York and surrounding area, before returning home 1085-. Canute, now king, planned a major invasion against England, but the assembled fleet never sailed. There were no serious invasions or raids of England by the Danes after this. Geography. See also, Five Boroughs of the Danelaw. The Five Boroughs and the English Midlands. In the early 10th century, the area occupied by the Danelaw was roughly the area to the north of a line drawn between London and Chester, excluding the portion of Northumbria to the east of the Pennines. Five fortified towns became particularly important in the Danelaw: Leicester, Nottingham, Derby, Stamford and Lincoln, broadly delineating the area now called the East Midlands. These strongholds became known as the Five Boroughs. Borough derives from the Old English word burg, cognate with German burg, meaning castle, meaning a fortified and walled enclosure containing several households, anything from a large stockade to a fortified town. The meaning has since developed further legal concepts. The Danelaw was an important factor in the establishment of a civilian peace in the neighbouring Anglo-Saxon and Viking communities. It established, for example, equivalences in areas of legal contentiousness, such as the amount of reparation that should be payable in wargild. Many of the legalistic concepts were compatible, for example, the Viking wapentake, the standard for land division in the Danelaw, was effectively interchangeable with the hundred. The use of the execution site and cemetery at Wokington Wold in East Yorkshire suggests a continuity of judicial practice. Legacy toponymy within the southern kingdom of Jorvik, showing the lasting legacy of Danish settlement. The influence of this period of Scandinavian settlement can still be seen in the north of England and the East Midlands, and is particularly evident in place names, name endings such as how, by meaning village or thorpe, hamlet, having Norse origins. There seems to be a remarkable number of Kirkby names, some with remains of Anglo-Saxon building indicating both a Norse origin and early church building. Scandinavian names blended with the English tongue give rise to typical hybrid place names. Old East Norse and Old English were still somewhat mutually comprehensible. The contact between these languages in the Danelaw caused the incorporation of many Norse words into the English language, including the word law itself, sky and window, and the third-person pronouns they, them, and their. Many Old Norse words still survive in the dialects of Northern England. Four of the five boroughs became county towns. Of the counties of Leicestershire, Lincolnshire, Nottinghamshire and Derbyshire, however, Stamford failed to gain such status, perhaps because of the nearby autonomous territory of Rutland. Genetic heritage. See also, Genetic History of the British Isles and Scandinavian Migration to the United Kingdom. In 2000, the BBC commissioned a genetic survey of the British Isles by a team from University College London led by Professor David Goldstein for its programme, Blood of the Vikings. It concluded that Norse invaders settled sporadically throughout the British Isles with a particular concentration in certain areas, such as Orkney and Shetland. In this finding, the Vikings refers to Norwegian Vikings only, as the study did not set out to genetically distinguish descendants of Danish Vikings from descendants of Anglo-Saxon settlers. That was decided on the basis that the latter two groups originated from areas that overlap each other on the continental North Sea coast ranging from the Jutland Peninsula to Belgium and were therefore deemed inconvenient or difficult to genetically distinguish. A further genetic study in 2015 found some evidence that, after the Vikings began settling, the communities had lived side by side and not intermingled for the first 100 years before going on to become a homogeneous genetic group. It also found no evidence of the introduction of Viking genes during the earlier raiding period, suggesting that the raiders did not participate in rape, or at least no children were produced from such actions. Archaeology. Major archaeological sites that bear testimony to the Danelaw are few. The most famous is the site at York. Another Danelaw site is the cremation site at Heath Wood, Ingleby. Derbyshire archaeological sites do not bear out the historically defined area as being a real demographic or trade boundary. This could be due to misallocation of the items and features on which this judgment is based as being indicative of either Anglo-Saxon or Norse presence. Otherwise, it could indicate that there was considerable population movement between the areas, or simply that after the treaty was made, it was ignored by one or both sides. Thinghow was an important Danelaw meeting place, today located in Sherwood Forest, in Nottinghamshire. The word how often indicates a prehistoric burial mound. How is derived from the Old Norse word hogr, meaning mound. The site's rediscovery was made by Linda Mallett, Stuart Reddish and John Wood. The site had vanished from modern maps and was essentially lost to history until the local history enthusiasts made their discoveries, experts think the rediscovered site, which lies amidst the old oaks of an area known as the Birklands in Sherwood Forest, may also yield clues as to the boundary of the ancient Anglo-Saxon kingdoms of Mercia and Northumbria. English Heritage recently inspected the site and believes it is a national rarity. Thinghow was a place where people came to resolve disputes and settle issues. It is a Norse word, although the site may be older still, perhaps even from the Bronze Age. See also list of generic forms in British place names. Longhouse, Mjolnir, Norse Gales, Raven Banner. Runestone Stave Church Subpoena Ad Testificandum Valknut. References Carrot M. Pons Sons 2007 Norse Derived Vocabulary in Late Old English Texts. Wolfstand's Works A Case Study. Amsterdam, P.O. Box 36224, John Benjamin's Publishing Company, p. 157. Carrot S. Thomason, T. Kaufman, Language Contact, Creolization and Genetic Linguistics, p. 362. Carrot The Blackwell Encyclopedia of Anglo-Saxon England, ed. Michael Lappage 2008, p. 136. Carrot Sawyer The Oxford Illustrated History of the Vikings, pp. 52-55. Carrot ASC 865. Carrot ASC 878. 1965. Carrot Introduction, Biddulf, Joseph. Old Danish of the Old Danelaw. Pontypridd, 2003. ISBN 978-1-897999-48-6. Carrot The Grimston Hybrids, noted by Richard Hall, Viking Age Archaeology Series, Shire Archaeology 2010-22. Carrot Henry Loyne, The Vikings in Britain. Cambridge, Blackwell Publishers, 1995, 85. Carrot Joan Beale, English Dialects in the North of England, Morphology and Syntax, in a Handbook of Varieties of English, Volume 2, ed. Berndt Kortmann et al. New York, Martin de Gruyter, 2004137. Carrot Katie Wales, Northern English, A Social and Cultural History. Cambridge, Cambridge University Press, 2006, 55. Carrot G. H. Cowling, The Dialect of Hackness, Northeast Yorkshire. Cambridge, Cambridge University Press, 1915, XXIXXII. Carrot England, Viking Blood Still Flowing. BBC News 3 December 2001 retrieved 23 April 2010. Carrot http://bacook/news/science-environment-31905764. Carrot Stahl, Anka Beate May 2004 Guide to Scandinavian Origins of Place Names in Britain PDF Ordnance Survey retrieved 7 August 2014. Definitions from Wiktionary. Media from Commons. News from Wikinews. Quotations from Wikiquote. Texts from Wikisource. Textbooks from Wikibooks. Learning resources from Wikiversity. News item, BBC Blood of the Vikings. BBC Viking History. Links according to ancient custom, research on the possible origins and purpose of Thinghow. Sherwood Forest. Coordinates, 54 degrees north 1 degree west, 54 degrees north 1 degree west, 54.-1 VE. Scandinavian England. People Amelieb Quarren Canute the Great. Eoric of East Anglia. Eric Bloodaxe. Eric Hawkinson. Jytha Thorkelsdottir. Gofraid Ua Imer. Guthrid Guthrum. Guthrum II. Halfdan Ragnarsson. Harthacknut. Harold Harefoot. House of Nillinga. Ivar the Boneless. Norse Gales. Olaf Guthfrithson. Ragnall Ua Imer. Ragnar Lodbrok. Scandinavian migration to the United Kingdom. Citric Cac Seward, Earl of Northumbria. Svein Knutsen. Swain Forkbeard. Thorkel the Tall. Thorbrand the Hold. Uba cites Danelaw. North Sea Empire. Scandinavian York Culture and Artifacts. Battle of Brunanbur. Poem Quirdale Hoard. England Runestones. Furnace Hoard. Old Norse Silverdale Hoard. Vale of York Hoard. Etymology. List of English words of Old Norse origin. List of places in Cheshire. List of places in County Durham. List of places in Cumbria. List of places in Derbyshire. List of places in Lancashire. List of places in Leicestershire. List of places in Lincolnshire. List of places in Merseyside. List of places in Norfolk. List of places in Northamptonshire. List of places in Nottinghamshire. List of places in Rutland. List of places in Yorkshire. Lowestoft. Rugby. Thingwall. Thinghow. Battles. Battle of Brunanbur. Battle of Stamford Bridge. Authority. Control. WorldCat. Identities. VIAF, 238,973,747. GND, 4,011,010-2.